In this video, we'll take a look at the path data type and flow variables of type path. The path data type is used to point to a file or a folder within a file system. A path type consists of three parts. The type specifies the file system type, which can be local file system, mount point, relative to, custom or KNIME URL, or connected. The specifier provides additional file system specific information, for example, the relative location or the name of the mount point. The path specifies a location within the file system and a file or a folder name and extension. The parts of a path correspond to the file location settings in most reader and writer nodes. Paths also have their own dedicated flow variable type. Let's take a look at an example. This workflow reads the Excel file containing the data on some unpaid invoices. Then it calculates the number of days between the due date and the current date. After that, it filters only the invoices that should have already been paid by today, and finally saves the data to another Excel file. This new Excel file should be called after today's date. We want to repeat this process every day. Now, how can we write a new Excel file automatically on a daily basis? The date and time configuration node produces the execution date as a flow variable of type string. This variable is used to filter the data on a daily basis, but we can't use it directly to overwrite the file name in the Excel writer node. We can only overwrite the entire file path with a path flow variable. The create file folder variables node can create a flow variable of type path. The minimum configuration of the create file folder variables node is to select the type, the specifier, and the location. The output of the node is the selected folder as a path flow variable. We can further create path flow variables for files in the base location. We define the file names and extensions in this table. If we want to change the name of the path flow variable, we can double-click the current name and write the new name. The base location is provided as defined here above. We can write the file name here in the value column and the file extension here in the last column. If we want to create multiple path flow variables, for example, one for the base location and another for a file within it, we can add a new row by clicking Add Variable here on the right. Let's check the output again. We now have a new path flow variable with the type, specifier, base location, file name, and extension as we defined in the table. In our example, we want to create a path flow variable that points to a specific file. Therefore, we connect the date and time configuration node containing the flow variable with the current date to the create file folder variables node. We overwrite the value setting with the current date flow variable in the flow variables tab. In the output of the node, we can now see the path flow variable with today's date as the file name. This flow variable can now be passed to the Excel writer node and used to control the output location of the Excel writer. Once the workflow is re-executed on a new day, the file name changes. The new file with today's data is then saved in the same folder, but with the relevant name. One final note. If you need to convert path cells or path flow variables to string, or vice versa, the path to string variable, string to path, and string to path variable nodes will do that for you. In this video, we demonstrated the usage and constituent parts of the path data type, how to create a flow variable of type path, how to automate the update of such a variable based on other flow variables, how to use path flow variables to overwrite reader and writer node settings, and how to convert type path to type string and vice versa.